effective in its prescriptions, and the president accepts and endorses all of that. I would note, if I may, because nobody's asked, but there has been also in that report a discussion of the interagency process, of which there had been a great deal of reporting and, as it turns out, much of it inaccurate, because it says, and I quote, "The interagency response was timely and appropriate, but there was simply not enough time, given the speed of the attacks, for armed U.S. military assets to have made a difference. Senior-level interagency discussions were underway soon after Washington received initial word of the attacks and continued through the night. And as you know, when the president was notified, that was the first thing he ordered, was that the Defense Department, the CIA, and others do everything they can as quickly as they could to assist. The board found no evidence of any undue delays in decision-making or denial of support from Washington or from the military combatant commanders. Quite the contrary. The safe evacuation of all U.S. government personnel from Benghazi 12 hours after the initial attack and subsequently to Ramstein Air Force Base was the result of exceptional U.S. government coordination and military response and helped save the lives of two severely wounded Americans. In addition, at the State Department's request, the Defense Department also provided a Marine FAST team, a Fleet Anti-Terrorism Security Team, as additional security support for Embassy Tripoli on September 12th.
That question of accountability, though, when Ben, I think, made the point that before the election, the president in a debate said he took responsibility for Benghazi. Before the election, Secretary Clinton did a series of interviews, I think, in Peru, where she said she took responsibility. But now, after the election, after the report comes out, we hear about three or four State Department people taking the fall. How is it that they're taking responsibility when the president and Secretary of State say...
So let me just get this straight. The president and the Secretary of State order immediately an accountability review board headed by two individuals who are admired broadly across the political spectrum in Washington, who have served their country admirably in the diplomatic service and in the military. That report is extremely detailed. It is very critical of both inadequacies in our security and in decisions and actions that were taken. Immediately, accountability has been brought to bear with regard to four individuals who are very senior. And your question is, why aren't they being, this is the State Department. The Secretary of State said she, understood that State Department, embassy security right. was on her watch and action has been taken.
Okay, but those people are taking the fall. I'm just asking. So the Secretary
they're
of
not
State.
Taking the fall,
well, what
Ed.
Are they doing? Somebody resigned.
Taking the fall suggests that this is an accountability and responsibility. That's what it is. What are you suggesting?
I'm just asking a question as to whether, as was asked already, about whether the accountability mm-hmm. ends with those people. People at higher levels said before the election that the buck stopped with them.
Well, I'm not sure what you're suggesting.
Did they say that before the election?
There were some individuals who made a lot of reporting that turned out to be entirely false based on the paragraph I just read,
sure.
Ed. And the facts in the report are the facts. The accountability that's been taken is being taken. I think it demonstrates the president's seriousness on this issue, a seriousness that is not just limited to steps we need to take to improve our security for our diplomats around the world, but